Hello everyone, myself Mitesh Savalia from Pravin Patil Polytechnic, lecturer in Electrical Engineering Department. In these previous videos, we have learned about the introduction of the capacitor, the construction and operation of the parallel plate capacitor. In the second video, we have learned about a connection of a capacitor, that is series connected capacitor, parallel connected capacitor, how the formula can be derived in the series connected capacitor and parallel connected capacitor. In the third video, we have learned about energy stored in the capacitor. That is the formula that can be derived for the work done of capacitor, stored energy or the stored charge of the capacitor. Now, this is the last video for the chapter number 3, unit number 3. In this video, we are going to learn about the charging and discharging process of capacitor. How the capacitor gets charged, how the capacitor gets discharged after charging. So that characteristics, that behavior of the capacitor, that we are going to learn in this video. So this is the charging of capacitor. The circuit is showing the connection, how the capacitor gets charged. ES is the input supply, that is battery. R is a resistance that is used to limit the charging current, and switch is used to turn on and turn off the charging current. And in the end, we have a capacitor that we have to charge, and voltage across that capacitor will be denoted by the VC, voltage across capacitor. Now, let us assume that the capacitor C is fully discharged. So make sure before starting this experiment, capacitor should be fully discharged and the switch S is fully open. These are the initial conditions of the circuit. Before starting the experiment, we should have these conditions, that capacitor should be fully discharged, switch is fully in open condition. Then, if we have these conditions, T is equal to 0, current will be 0, charge will be 0. When the switch is closed, the time begins at T is equal to 0. And current begins to flow into the circuit via the resistors. Since the initial voltage across the capacitor is 0, at T is equal to 0, the capacitors act as a short circuit to the external circuit. So the maximum amount of current will flow through the circuit, restricted by the resistance R. Then, by using the Kirchhoff's voltage law, that is KVL, the voltage drop around the circuit will be given by Vs minus I into R minus Vc equal to 0. Battery voltage minus drop in the resistance minus capacitor voltage will be equal to 0 according to the KVL. The current now flowing around the circuit is called as a charging current. The current which flows in this duration in the circuit, that current will be called as a charging current, and which is found by the formula using Ohm's law. The formula for Ohm's law is V is equal to I into R. Here we have to find the value of current, so we will use the formula I is equal to V upon R, but V will be the supply voltage, so I will be equal to Vs upon R. Now, as you can see from the graph, the above graph shows the graph of a charge stored across the capacitor, and the lower graph shows the current flowing in the capacitor. As you can see, when there is a zero charge, that is from origin, when there is a zero charge, there will be a maximum current flowing in a circuit. But when current starts flowing through the capacitor, charge across the capacitor gets starting developed. As the charge goes on increasing, as the stored charge goes on increasing across the capacitor, the current flowing in the capacitor goes on decreasing. As you can see from the diagram, the voltage, as soon as the voltage starts building up, charge starts gathering around the capacitor plates, the current flowing through the capacitor will start reducing. And when the point at which capacitor gets fully charged, at that point the current flowing through the capacitor will become zero. I can give you the practical example of this. If we keep our mobile phone in charging condition till 99% of charging, it will show the charging symbol in the battery in your phone. As soon as battery reaches the 100%, that charging symbol will get cut off because the current flowing in the circuit will become zero. Now we will see discharging of capacitor. Now here we have to remove the battery, and in place of battery we have to do short circuit because we have to take charge back from the capacitor. So we will replace the battery with the short circuit and the remaining circuit will remain same. Now RC discharging circuit, the time constant T is equal to the value of 63%. Then for RC discharging circuit, that is initially fully charged, the voltage across the capacitor after one time constant has dropped by 63% of its initial value, which is 1 minus 0.63, that is 0.37 of its final value. As the capacitor discharges, it does not lose its charge at a constant rate. The discharging of charge will not take place at constant rate. At the start of the discharging process, the initial conditions of the circuit will be T equal to 0, I will be equal to 0, and Q will be the stored charge, that is Q. The voltage across the capacitor plates is equal to the supply voltage V, that is, we can say that VC is equal to VS. As the voltage at T is equal to 0 across the capacitor plate is the highest value, the maximum discharge current will flow around the RC circuit. As we have a higher value, higher potential across the capacitor, higher discharging current will flow. As this charge goes on decreasing, the discharging current will also start decreasing. Thus, the time constant of the circuit is given as the time taken for capacitor to discharge down within the 63% of its fully charged value. So, one time constant for the RC discharge circuit is given as the voltage across the plates representing 37% of its final value, with its final value being 0 volts, that is, means fully discharged, and in our curve this is given as 0.37 volts. Now as you can see, the above circuit shows the reduction of voltage across the capacitor, and the lower circuit shows the reduction of current in the circuit. As we have a higher value of voltage, higher will be the discharging current. As the voltage across capacitor goes on decreasing while discharging, so the current also starts decreasing. So this was all about the charging and discharging of the capacitor, and here we are completing our unit number 3, that is capacitors. So if you have any doubt regarding connection of capacitor, introduction of capacitor, energy stored in capacitor, or charging or discharging of capacitor, any topic you have doubt, you can call me or else you can message me. Thank you.